Hello everyone! Welcome to Think Academy's Math Kangaroo class. So my name is Ting Ting and today we're going to look at a very fun math problem together, okay? So let's first read the question. Each of the shapes shown is made by gluing together four cubes of the same size and the shapes will be painted. So the question is asking which shape will have the smallest area to be painted? I have a question. Since we have four exactly the same cubes, and they should have the same number of faces, right? Then how can we have the smallest area? Do you notice anything? Yes, they're putting together, right? Okay, so in order to figure out the smallest area, let's look at a small example, okay? So for example, Ting Ting has two cubes. Cube one and cube two. My first question is, how many faces does one cube have? Very good, six, right? So, which means that for two cubes, we should have 6 + 6 = 12 faces. But what if Ting Ting puts them together? Do you think we will still have 12 faces? No, right? And why is that? Because actually, there are some hidden faces. See? We will have some hidden faces, right? So when we put two cubes together, there are two faces that are kissing with each other, right? And they are hidden. So we actually call these two faces a pair of kissing faces. And when we have one pair of kissing faces, we will have two hidden faces. Okay, so remember, when two cubes are connecting with each other, we will have two hidden faces, okay? So now, we can start with our choices to see that if we have any kissing faces, okay? So for example, for our choice A here, if we have cube A, cube B, cube C, and cube D, which two cubes are connecting with each other? Let's see. So, Ting Ting knows that A and B are connecting with each other, right? Do you see any other cubes that are connecting with each other? Very good. B and C, C and D, right? So, in total, we have 1, 2, 3 kissing faces. And we know that for each pair of kissing faces, we will have two hidden faces. So, the total number of hidden faces will be 3 × 2. Equals to 6. Okay, so now everyone knows how to find out the number of hidden faces, right? So how about the second one? How many hidden faces do we have? We have, let's first figure out how many of them are connecting with each other, okay? And we know that when we find, we want to find in order. So we can start with the horizontal connecting ones. So we know that A and B are connecting with each other. C and D are connecting with each other. Then we move to the vertical ones. For the vertical ones, we know that A and C are connecting and B and D are also connecting, right? So in total, we will have 4 × 2 = 8 hidden faces, right? Okay, so how about the next one? Can you guys tell me the answer? 6! How did you get 6? So we know that we have A, B, C, D, 4 cubes, right? And this time, we know A and B are connecting with each other. B and C are also connecting with each other. And finally, C and D. So in total, we will have 3 × 2 = 6. All right, so now we still have two more choices, right? So for choice D, we still know that we have A, B, C, and D. Can you guys try it by yourself to see how many hidden faces do we have? We have 6, right? So we have A and B, B and C and D. So in total, we're going to have 3 × 2 = 6 hidden faces. And finally, we have choice E, which is a two-layer shape, right? So again, remember, we want to find in order so we can start from top to the bottom. So if we are connecting top one to the bottom layer, what do we have? We know that this is A, B, C, and D, right? So we will know that this is going to be A and C. So after we check out the top layer, we're going to look at the bottom layer. So for the bottom layer, we have B and C connecting with each other, and also C and D. So in total, we're going to have 3 times 2 equals to 6 hidden faces. All right. So now we've figured out all the number of hidden faces for each choices. We just want to know which one have the smallest area, right? So in order to find out the smallest area, guys, we can actually look at here. So in order to figure out the smallest area, we know that if we use the total number of faces minus the hidden one, this will give us what? This will actually give us the number of faces, painted faces, right? Because in total, we know that in total, for each choices, supposedly they should have 6 times 4 equals to 24 faces. But because some of them are connecting with each other, so we will have the hidden ones, right? So if we subtracting the hidden ones, we will have the number of faces that we need to be painted. So that means that if we have the most number of hidden faces, then we will have the smallest number of painted faces, right? So let's see which choice have the most number. So we know that A have 6, B has 8, C has 6, D has 6, E has 6. So can you shout out the answer to me? Very good, B, right? So B is actually our final choices because only choice B have 8 hidden faces. And all the other ones only have 6 hidden faces, right? Okay, guys. So now you will know that in order to find out the smallest area to be painted for the same number of cubes, we can just find out how many kissing faces do we have. But remember, for each pair of kissing faces, we will have 2 hidden faces because when 2 of them are connecting with each other, there are 2 faces kissing with each other, right? Okay. So very good job, everyone. And I hope you guys enjoy this question together. And I will see you guys next time. Bye.